click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we'll learn how to create the toothpaste tube in SOLIDWORKS. So we'll be using surface modeling commands for SOLIDWORKS. So let's see. Now let's see how to create a toothpaste tube in SOLIDWORKS. So we'll go in SOLIDWORKS. Now here, select the front plane, click on the sketch. Now we'll first create one rectangular profile. So select one, select a rectangle and draw one rectangle. So I will take this as 0.5 and this length as 100. Now just exit the sketch. We'll just make visible the plane. Now go in the features, yeah, go in the reference geometry, select the plane. Now we'll create one reference plane of the front plane. So here I will take the distance as 100. Now select this plane, click on the sketch, make it normal too. Now here select ellipse and we'll just draw one ellipse. Now go in the smart dimension, we'll take this distance as 6 and this distance is total 100 from the this point to this point, that is the axis. And just exit this sketch. I just go in the plane one and reduce its distance. I will take the distance as 60. Click OK. Now again go in the reference geometry, select the plane, select this plane one, and from here take the distance of 100 and click OK. Now select this plane and click on the sketch, make it normal too. Now again we'll select the ellipse. Now here go in the smart dimension and take this distance as 25. Just exit the sketch. Again go in the reference geometry, select the plane option, select this and here take the distance as 40, click OK, select this plane, click on the sketch, here select one circle and draw one circle of diameter 25, exit the sketch. Now we'll first join this all. So for that I will just go in the surfacing. Here we'll select the lofted surface option. Select this sketch and this first ellipse. I'll just click OK. Now again select the lofted surface. Here select the elliptical sketch and select this sketch. We'll just clear the selection first. I'll just adjust this point, so just drag and click here. See, now the profile has been properly created. Just click OK. Now again go in the lofted surface, select this circle and select the bigger ellipse. Now here just in lofted, but the shape is not properly created. So I'll just go in the start and end constraint. Here select the normal to profile option, and for the end constraint also select the normal to profile option. See, we'll get the two portion of the front part. Just click OK. I will just hide these planes. I will go here and select the shaded view. See, for now it has created the initial toothpaste profile. Now we'll create the further profile. So now select the planar surface, select this, click OK. Now select this plane, click on the sketch, make it normal to. Select the circle command and draw one circle of say 17. Exit the sketch. Now just select this circle and select the trim surface command. Here we'll select the standard and just trim this. Click OK. Again, click on the sketch, select this face, make it normal to. Select the control entities and select this cut circle. Click OK. Now just exit the sketch. Now go in the surfaces and here select the extrude surface option and select this circle. Now here take the extrude distance as 5. Click OK. Now go in the features. From here go in the reference geometry, select the plane option, select this plane and take the reference. Now here we'll create the plane at a distance of 30. Click OK. Now just select this plane. Click on the sketch, make it normal to. Sorry, we'll select the other plane. So again go in the plane option, select this plane. In the second reference we'll select this edge. I will just give the distance, that is 5. Click OK. Now select this plane, click on the sketch, make it normal to. Here select the control entities and select this outer circle. Click OK. Now select the circle command. Here draw one circle. Select the trim entities and trim this half circle. Now we'll go in the circular sketch pattern. Select the entities to pattern. So we'll select this. And here increase the number. Here I will take 12 number of patterns. Sorry, we'll just take 11 number of patterns. Click OK. Now just select this circle and make it for construction geometry. Now here select the center point arc, select this center point and create a arc here. Now we'll pattern this arc also. So again go in the circular sketch pattern. Here select this arc and take 11 number of pattern. Click OK. Now just exit the sketch. Now select this plane, click on the sketch, make it normal too. Select the convert entities and select this inner circle, click OK. Now select one circle and draw one circle here of say 4. Now here go in the trim entities and just trim this half circle. Select this circle and make it to construction geometry. Now go in the circular sketch pattern. Go in the entities to pattern and select this semicircle. And here take the number of pattern as 11. Click OK. Now select center point arc. Here create one arc. I'll just again go in the center point arc. Again, go in the circular sketch pattern, select the arc to pattern, and here take the number of patterns 11, click OK. I'll just check whether all the arcs are properly created. Just exit the sketch. Now we'll go in the lofted surface. Select this and this profile. Click OK. Now I'll just hide this plane. Select the thinner surface. Now here just select the sketch. I'll just select this sketch. Okay. Again use the planar surface and select the second sketch. Click OK. That has been properly patched. Now just select this face. Click on sketch. Make it normal too. Select one circle and draw one circle here. Exit the sketch. Now just select this and select the trim surface command and select the inner portion, click OK. Again select the sketch command, click here, select the current entities and from here just select this circle that we have created, click OK, exit the sketch, go in the surface, select the extrude surface option, select this circle, just reverse the direction. I will just take the distance as 8 and on the draft command and give some draft degree. Click OK. Now just select the planar surface. Now just select this edge. Click OK. Now it has been properly closed. Now this is our proper toothpaste and this is the yield. Now just select planar surface once again and we'll just patch this. Now we can just go in the surface block first and select this sketch one, click OK. I will just hide this plane. I'll provide the appearance. So I'll just go in the appearances. I'll just select the paint. I'll select this red and click on the body. Go in the appearance here and just drag and drop on this other body. Now for this I'll use some white color. I'll just drag and drop on this body. So like this we can create a toothpaste tube using the surface modeling commands in SolidWorks. Thank you friends for watching this video.